Volcanoes don't sit quietly like most other mountains. They explode. Picture rivers of fiery lava, towering clouds of ash, and rumbling sounds that shake the ground. Volcanic eruptions are natural wonders. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. All right, let's break it down. What exactly is a volcanic eruption? Imagine a mountain, a big one. Except this mountain isn't just sitting there looking pretty. Nope, it's got some serious action going on inside. Things are heating up. Pressure is building up. A volcanic eruption is when the volcano just can't take it anymore, and all the pent-up stuff is released. Whew! The big mess includes molten rock called magma, gases, and ash. Of course, we can't have a volcanic eruption without one very important ingredient. Lava. Lava is what we call molten rock after it comes out of a volcano. Did you know there's more than one kind of lava? Each one behaves a little differently. The two main types of lava are called mafic and felsic. Mafic lava is runny and hot, so it flows quickly. It forms rocks like basalt, which is dark and dense. On the other hand, felsic lava is thicker and cooler, so it doesn't flow as far. It forms rocks like rhyolite, which is lighter in color and often contains crystals. We have a special name for rocks that are formed out of lava after it cools down and solidifies. Igneous rocks. One way to remember this word is that it's related to ignite, because these rocks were so hot they were practically on fire. Just how hot does lava get? Up to 1,200 degrees Celsius. That's a lot hotter than your oven on its hottest setting. As for speed, lava can flow at different rates depending on how runny it is and the slope of the ground. Some lava flows can crawl along at just a few feet per hour, while others can race downhill at speeds of up to 30 miles per hour. But lava is just one of the many things that come out of a volcano during eruptions. When volcanoes erupt, they spit out all sorts of stuff. In addition to lava, there's volcanic ash, which is made up of tiny bits of crushed rock and glass. Volcanic ash is so fine that it can travel extremely far in the air, like a dusty cloud. And don't forget about the gases. Volcanoes can release all kinds of gases, like water vapor, carbon dioxide, the stuff we breathe out, sulfur dioxide, which smells like rotten eggs, and hydrogen sulfide, which smells like bad breath. Want to take home a souvenir? Visit our website for smart, fun posters that are funny and fact-filled. Find the link below. Volcanoes are just downright ill-tempered, as mountains go. But have you ever wondered why volcanoes blow their tops? It's all about pressure. Picture this. Deep beneath the Earth's surface, tectonic plates, the giant puzzle pieces that make up Earth's crust, are constantly on the move. Sometimes they collide, causing immense pressure to build up. Other times, magma gets trapped in underground chambers, heating up and expanding like a pressure cooker. When the pressure becomes too much to handle, boom. The volcano erupts. It's sort of like a soda bottle shaken too hard. Eventually, it has to release all that built-up fizz. There is actually a way to measure how big and powerful volcanic eruptions are. Who would want to do that? Volcanologists. Yep. That's what we call scientists who study volcanoes. The Volcanic Explosivity Index, or VEI for short, is like a ruler for measuring volcanic eruptions. The scale goes from 0 to 8, with 0 being the smallest eruptions and 8 being the biggest ones. So if a volcano gets a high VEI score, you know it means serious business. Super volcanoes are a special category of volcanoes that have an extremely large eruption, scoring an 8 on the VEI. The most famous supervolcano can be found in Yellowstone National Park in the United States and is called the Yellowstone Caldera. It makes up a huge part of this national park. Speaking of sizes, volcanoes come in all shapes and sizes, which also means they have different kinds of eruptions. There are shield volcanoes like the Mauna Loa, Mauna Kea, and Kilauea. These can be recognized by broad, gentle slopes formed by the flow of fluid lava. Then there's stratovolcanoes like Mount Fuji. These are tall, steep-sided mountains built up by alternating layers of lava, ash, and volcanic rocks. These volcanoes usually have very explosive eruptions. Lastly, there are cinder cone volcanoes like Wizard Island in Crater Lake National Park. These are smaller, steep-sided cones formed from ejected volcano fragments. Volcanic eruptions can be pretty intense, and they bring along some hazards that we've got to watch out for. First up, there are lava flows. These are rivers of molten rock that can burn everything in their path. There are also pyroclastic flows, which are like super hot avalanches of gas, ash, and rock that race down the volcano at crazy high speeds. They're like fiery hurricanes. Lastly, there are volcanic gases like sulfur dioxide, carbon dioxide, and hydrogen sulfide, which can be really harmful to breathe in. Basically, you don't want to get near anything coming out of a volcano. While we're on the topic of volcanoes spewing fiery lava and releasing gas and ash into the air, let's think about what that could mean for the planet. Is there an impact on our environment? Keep in mind, just because something is natural doesn't mean it's good for all of nature. Volcanoes are pretty rough on living things. All the plants and animals in the path of lava flows are going to be wiped out. But it doesn't stop there. Harmful gases and ash can hang around in the atmosphere and form what's called a volcanic cloud. These clouds can be really thick, kind of like a giant umbrella blocking out the sunlight. This means less energy for photosynthesis, which affects both wild plants and plants growing on farms. With less sunlight reaching the Earth's surface, it can also cause the climate to cool down for a while. It's like putting on a really big pair of sunglasses for the whole planet. Scientists call this temporary cooling effect volcanic winter. So while volcanoes are known for their fiery eruptions, they can also throw a bit of shade and cool things down for a bit. Some of the biggest volcanic eruptions in history have left a lasting impression on our world. One famous eruption happened in 79 CE when Mount Vesuvius in Italy blew its top and buried the city of Pompeii under a thick layer of ash and pumice. Another well-known eruption is the 1815 eruption of Mount Tambora in Indonesia, which was the most powerful eruption recorded in history. It spewed out so much ash and gas that it caused an epic volcanic winter, leading to crop failures and even a year without a summer in some parts of the world. So where can you even find volcanoes? Volcanoes are scattered all over the world, both on land and underwater. Can you believe that? Even the ocean floor has volcanoes. Many of Earth's volcanoes are found in the Pacific Ring of Fire, which is like a horseshoe-shaped area in the Pacific Ocean where lots of volcanic action happens. But volcanoes aren't picky. They can pop up anywhere there's enough heat and pressure beneath the Earth's surface. After all that spewing of lava and whatnot, you might wonder, do volcanoes ever run out? Well, sort of. We say the volcano has become extinct. This means that the volcano is no longer active and is unlikely to erupt again. However, it's important to note that describing a volcano as extinct is not always straightforward. Some volcanoes may appear to be extinct for thousands or even millions of years, but they can potentially reactivate if there are changes in the geology of the Earth. So we never really know if they are actually, well, extinct. Scientists keep a close eye on volcanoes to help keep people safe. They use special tools to detect earthquakes that happen underground when magma moves around. They also use gas detectors to sniff out gases like sulfur dioxide that volcanoes release before erupting. And guess what? They even use satellites to take pictures from space to see if a volcano is getting ready to blow. Generally, it's safest to be several miles away from an active volcano to avoid the risk of lava flow. However, in some cases, lava can travel much farther, especially if it's moving downhill or if the eruption is particularly powerful. Because of this, it's very important to follow the advice of local authorities and evacuation plans to ensure your safety during a volcanic eruption. Volcanic eruptions are like nature reminding us of the incredible forces at work beneath our feet. So while volcanoes may be unpredictable and sometimes destructive, they also help us to understand the inner workings of our planet. They're naturally wonderful. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.